The goal is very simple. Show that a new type of forces exist in nature. These forces arise when the energy moves in matter. Since the energy can have different forms, this type of force also has different forms. This conclusion follows directly from the already existing and generally accepted laws of physics. Here I list the different types of forces that I have heard about. Abraham believed that optically induced forces exist also in a homogeneous optical medium. At first glance, this cannot be, since the momentum of light in a homogeneous optical medium does not change, and therefore it does not produce forces in the optical medium. Abraham believed that the density of forces produced in matter by an electromagnetic wave is determined by the following formula. Let us start with the very basics. What is a force, and where does it come from? According to Newton's second law, a force is responsible for changing the momentum of an object. If the momentum of light changes, then a force determined by the first formula takes place. This force acts from the side of the matter, then in accordance with Newton's third law, the opposite force acts on the matter from the side of light, determined by the second formula. Unfortunately, at present, a generally accepted opinion about the magnitude of the momentum of light in an optical medium is absent, and all our further considerations are sensorless. On the past 10 years, we have given more than a dozen arguments in favor of the fact that, in accordance with known and generally accepted laws of physics and optics, Minkowski was right. This gives us grounds for further analysis. As an example, only one of the arguments is shown here, that the momentum of light is proportional to the refractive index. From the condition that the side component of the momentum at refraction remains unchanged, we have red formula. On the other hand, from the Snell law, we have green formula. From red and green formulas, we have black formula, in accordance with which the momentum of light in matter is proportional to its refractive index. We can get the same result for wave on arbitrary type. In this case, the special period of the on the boundary between media, between the incident and the transmitted waves must be the same. In this case, we have the shown sequence of transformations from which the Snell law follows as is a special case for a light wave. Later, we will use the concept of the momentum density flux. This is a vector. Its value is equal to the energy density of the wave, and its direction coincides with the direction of the wave propagation. If the momentum density flux of the wave changes, then the wave produces such pressure. The energy density of a wave is in inverse proportion to its speed. Then the pressure in the case of decreasing duration is determined by the first formula. As a sin, if the wave speed decreases, then the pressure is negative, that is directed in direction opposite to the wave propagation. However, another irrefutable argument is known also based on generally accepted laws of physics, according to which the pressure is directed along the propagation of the wave. Let four reflectors be installed on a cart that can move freely in the horizontal direction. The red source in its pulse of light, which it successively reflects from reflectors 1, 2, 3, 4, and returned to the source. The pulse requires a positive momentum when it is reflected from reflector 1, and the cut momentum becomes negative. Green shows that the speed of the cut is negative until the pulse is reflected from reflector 2. In this case, the horizontal component of the momentum of the pulse and the cut disappears simultaneously. The cut stops, it stands until the pulse is reflected from reflector 3. The pulse requires a negative momentum, and the cut momentum becomes positive. The cut moves until the pulse is reflected from reflector 4. The yellow color shows the dependence of the distance on time. The cut returns to its original position. Now, on the path of the pulse, we put a transparent block into which the pulse penetrates without reflection. The pulse propagates in the block at low speed, so the time between reflections from reflector 3 and 4 increases. As a result, the cut will travel a greater distance, and the center mass of the system will change. This cannot be in an isolated system. In order for the center of mass of the cut not to change, it must be assumed that the pulse transfer a part of its momentum to the cut and makes it move in the negative direction. Consider a process of an interaction of the pulse and block. Yellow shows a change in the additional speed of the cut caused by the pulse. Upon entering the block, the speed gradually increases over time period equal to period of pulse duration. When the pulse propagates in the block, the speed of the cut does not change. When the pulse leaves the block, the additional speed of the cut disappears. By differentiating the speed, we have the acceleration. Acceleration is created by pressure. Why is pressure is created when the pulse enters the block? Why the pressure is absent when the pulse is propagating within the block? We need to conclude that the additional pressure are produced by the leading and trailing edges of the pulse. Simple calculations show that the center of mass of the system is not violated if the cut Сенс патов за моментом уже блок. This path is presented by blue formula. We have qualitatively different results. On the one hand, from the inducible result that the momentum of light in an optical medium increases, we have the pressure designated by number one. From the Ballas experiment, we have another pressure designated by number two. For the agreement, we need to assume that the leading edge of the pulse at the entrance to the block and the trailing edge of the pulse at the exit of the block create additional pressures determined by number three. This pressure can be determined from the following consideration. The additional pressures produced by the leading and trailing edges of the pulse is presented by red formula. Passing from the pressure to the density force, we obtain the blue formula. For particular case of an electromagnetic wave, we obtain the same Abraham formula presented green color. Any wave consists of a sequence of pulses of energy. Therefore, a continuous wave also produces additional pressure and additional density force. In a general case, the formula for the density force produced by an arbitrary type of wave can be presented green color. As can be seen, these forces depend only on two parameters, the wave speed and the energy density flux, that is, on the wave intensity. For each type of wave, the energy it carries consists of two types. For example, the types of energy for four types of wave are presented here. For all types of wave, the total force density is determined by this expression in violet color. In a particular case, an electromagnetic wave. The density of new forces can be represented by the formula in the red color. This expression can be presented in a more familiar form in blue color, which is currently used to calculate forces in alternating electric and magnetic fields by means of using the Lorentz forces. For comparison, the formula proposed by Einstein and Laon in 1908 is presented by Green. Blue arrows indicate discrepancies. Here, a special case is presented for new forces arising at propagation of elastic sound waves. The new force consists of two types. One force in red color is produced when the kinetic energy changes along the trajectory. The second force in blue color arises when the potential energy changes due to the deformation of the medium. Red and blue density forces are new, unknown early types of forces inherent to elastic sound waves. Similar approach can be used for another types of forces, in particular for sphere waves and capillary waves. In a general case, there are two new types of forces for each type of waves, since a propagation of any wave is accompanied by a change of two different types of energy. The general formula for this case was presented earlier by Violet Fowler. Here, a comparison of the formulas for sound and light wave is shown. This was shown earlier. The new forces are determined by the change in the energy density. For sound wave, this is the density of the kinetic and potential energy due to an elastic compression. For a light wave, these are the density of electrical and magnetic energy. It is possible to compare parameters of sound and light waves. The speed of the displacement of the medium in the sound wave is analog of the strength of the electrical field, and the kinetic energy of the sound wave is analog of the electrical energy of the light wave. Here, parameters of sound and the light waves are compared. As you can see, the parameters of these waves are completely different. They have different designation and different physical meanings. The total energy of these waves consists of two components that have a completely different physical nature. However, the new forces are determined by the same formula, where the specific of a particular type of wave disappears and only parameters common for each wave remain. In short, we have shown that the new types of forces that are produced by an arbitrary type of wave in the medium in which it propagates. The forces are directed along the propagation of the wave and are proportional to the energy density of the wave and are inversely proportional to its velocity. More details are on the site number 20. Thank you for your attention.